89.7 The River, music from the Red Hot Chili Peppers. It's called Dark Necessities, and it's such a sexy song at this time of the morning.
My goodness.
And that's why we bring in the sexiest part of the show.
Okay.
Elise.
Hi. That was, man, you know what? I'll tell you what.
Yes.
There's a point of contention, not really contention, but
that you're the sexiest member of your band?
That goes to John and Jack and how much they love each other.
Oh,
I'm kidding.
I thought it was the drummer that you had with three arms and four legs.
Yeah, that would be her. when a guitarist writes for a drummer. No, getting hit on makes me extremely uncomfortable.
Yeah.
I told Jordan that one time and he's like, baloney, like BS, like you get hit on all the time at shows. I'm like, and I feel awkward. I don't know what to do. Please don't hit on me. Ugh, can we just be friends?
Makes me nauseous. National Grilled Cheese Day.
Yeah, it is. Do you like grilled cheeses?
Yeah, of course. The real point I was trying to make was, which way do you cut your sandwich?
I don't.
You don't cut your sandwich?
Mainly because I put it on gluten-free bread. I don't do well with gluten.
And gluten-free bread is like, what, hard to cut?
No.
It's like beef jerky when you're trying to slice through it. It's all sinewy and stuff.
No, it's actually really good. But like the problem is it's like 3 inches by 3 inches.
Oh.
So you're already like, it's already cut in half.
It's just a baby.
It's just a baby.
I love little baby sandwiches.
I feel as though you cut yours diagonally. Diagonally into fours.
I was thinking about this.
How do you cut yours?
Sometimes it's diagonal and sometimes it's just in half across from top to bottom.
Okay.
I don't do it the same every time.
Okay.
And I don't cut it all the time.
Okay. Wow, you just live life on...
I'm as much as I like things in their place, I don't have an order when it comes to sandwiches.
Next question. What kind of cheeses do you put inside of it?
Just depends on what's available, I guess.
Yeah, that's the beauty.
Like grilled cheese, I'll go with American cheese. I'll go with the Kraft singles, even though I know that's not cheese. But it's, but I mean, that's it, whatever. You're melting it anyway, right? What difference does it make?
I know.
But we usually get this one pack of cheese when we go shopping.
Okay.
And it comes with assorted. It comes with Gouda.
Ooh.
It comes with Havarti.
Ooh.
It comes with cheddar. Oh. And a Swiss, I think. There's a Swiss.
Wow. See,
I think Swiss is my least favorite cheese.
I was going to say, out of those, I leave Swiss off. If it's not on rye or a Reuben, I don't want Swiss.
Yeah.
Swiss has its place.
It does?
Spicy chicken. Swiss is good on that.
Okay.
But like, I never buy Swiss.
I don't hate Swiss. I just don't care for it. I just don't like choose it.
You know, the other thing I started doing is I don't buy shredded cheese anymore.
Really?
So my tummy started hurting after I eat shredded cheese. And I'm like, what's going on? One of my friends who's a nutritionist said, well, that's because they put a glutinous powder all over it.
To keep it separated?
To keep it separated. And so... I just started doing block cheese, and then I grind it all at home myself.
Hold on just a second.
Keep it separated.
Sorry.
Thanks so much.
I thought Noodles needed to stop by. Tickets, by the way, for River Summer Bash become available this morning at 10 a.m. if you haven't scored them already through the River presale, 10 a.m. for The Offspring, The Urge, Save Ferris, and Straight Jacket. On July 23rd at the Astro.
Amazing. I'm going to tell you because...
How did we get there? Oh, yeah, because you said Noodles.
Noodles, yeah. Well, no, I said keep it separated.
Oh, that's right.
But anyway, moral of the story is now I buy block cheese and it's much meltier.
I said Noodles.
You said Noodles.
I love block cheese. I love slicing block cheese,
uh-huh.
But I'm very inconsistent when it comes to slicing it.
Yeah? You do thick and thin and...
Well, some of it's thick, some of it's thin, some of it's odd-shaped. Like, you know, you get that one piece that's got like a... It looks like Idaho.
Mm, yeah. A little like wonky slice.
I'm like, why doesn't this... Maybe it's because my cheese slicer is bad.
Oh, do you have a cheese slicer? Is it one of those like string thingies?
No, it's one of the... It's like... It looks like a shovel. It's got a slit in it and you scrape the shovel along it.
Oh! Okay, there's so many different versions of cheese slicing.
What kind of cheese slicer do you use?
So a knife? Well, I use a knife mainly, but
That's not a knife. This is a knife.
The cheese slice that I grew up with was like a Rolly bar. And then
I don't like those.
You don't like those?
I don't like those, no.
Okay, yeah.
I feel like they're hard to get the cheese off of the Rolly bar.
Oh, yeah. You gotta let it like get it off there.
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, do you do mayo or butter on yours?
Butter. I heard you've... I've I believe on this show, we've said, somebody suggested that mayo actually makes it browner and toastier.
Yeah, toastier. It gives a little extra, not like you don't taste the mayo, but you taste like the zing that you are missing when you make it at home.
What about using pancake batter on it?
Like, really? Have you done this?
No, but I'm thinking I'm going to.
Oh, I don't know.
It's National Grilled Cheese Day. It's finally freaking Friday. The weekend is mine.
The weekend is yours. Do what you want. Do you make tomato soup with it?
Not on a hot day, no.
Not on a hot day. No, gazpacho.
No, I don't like cold soup at all.
Oh, okay.
No.
Now,
I'll have a cold glass of water instead.
Wow.
Do you dip it in ketchup, honey mustard?
Never.
Nothing.
No. But let me tell you what I've done in the past is I've made like garlic grilled cheese, like garlic bread grilled cheese.
You're fancy.
You know what? I love cooking. And that's
Have you ever made two grilled cheese sandwiches and used it as the top and bottom of a hamburger?
I've never gotten I've never been in an impaired state where that sounded like a good idea.
Are you kidding? Impaired? Would that be what COVID quarantine was? Impaired state?
Oh, that, yeah, towards the end, absolutely.
I literally made that one afternoon. I was like, check it out. Jesus!
What'd you put in the middle? What'd you put
a between cheeseburger.
Them? A cheeseburger between them.
No, I didn't put cheese on the burger because there's already cheese in the sandwich.
A burger betwixt the grilled cheese.
Between
cheeses.
Two grilled cheese, yeah.
Wow, yeah. I like that. Zombie Burger has mac and cheese.
So anyway, it's National Grilled Cheese Day.
Oh, okay. Well, they put mac and cheese in their buns.
This conversation has really taken a turn, and everybody that's driving that hasn't eaten yet is like... Now we're hungry. Thanks a lot.
I wish we had a grilled cheese bar here in Omaha.
I wish we had a grilled cheese maker right in this room.
Well, we can.
I think we should just have a shelf full of all the appliances that we need to make the delicious things that we talk about in the mornings.
We should. We should just start this is now a cooking show. Morning Fiasco, the cooking show.
Yeah, yeah. Cooking up fun.
That's it. Hopefully.
The sliver.
What's up, guys?
Did you hear the news for all those people that have been asking about Rockfest and River Riot? Did you hear the news?
I'm not going to say anything in case. Shut up.
No, we haven't. No, yeah.
That's why I don't say anything.
Oh, how's it going? How's it going, YouTube people?
Hello, YouTube, my old friend. Jake was over here yesterday. Now I gotta figure out my settings.
All I did was delete that stuff to put Corey's description in.
No, I have to find the chat. Actually, I can do this. This will save a step. Ah, no. I'm just giving him crap today, guys, because
who's giving me crap?
Me, I'm giving you crap.
You are?
Well, yeah, because like I'm like, where's my chat? Just because Jake genuinely cares. He never wants to like interrupt someone's success.
It's not bothering me. Wow. I'm just watching Hoarders.
Wow. Hoarders.
On Wednesday, you can watch Take My Tumor at 9 Central.
Take My Tumor?
Yep.
We were talking about Pimp My Ride for Bonita. Like, on the way back, Ashley was like, I just wish Exhibit had Pimp My Ride still. And I was like, no, because the only thing I would want
is
fixed.
Is he dead?
Exhibit? Is he dead? Yeah. Did he die? Yes. R.I.P.
Pretty sure.
The only thing that I would want them to do is fix the engine and like the mechanics, and I would love to like redo all of it.
I want them to put a fish tank in the back.
But see, exactly. Like I could do that. I can do all the inside stuff. Me and Jerry, we could do all the inside stuff. We don't need Exhibit to be messing with that.
Oh no, he's still alive. Sorry.
Okay.
Who was I talking about?
O.J. Simpson.
He died, definitely.
He definitely died.
My bad, Exhibit. Exhibit and I share a birthday.
Do you?
No, we don't.
Cinco de Exhibit.
He was born in September.
Ouch.
He was born in September.
It's almost his birthday. No, not even close. What day is this? Where are we?
Today's April.
April. Earlier, I was like, yeah, I've been here for 2 years. And I was like, no, 2 years in July. So it hasn't been 2 years yet.
Right.
What a wild ride it's been.
It'll be next March for 2 years with me.
Yeah, that's right.
If we make it that long.
We will. Why wouldn't we? Oh, my gosh.
Because we
suck.
We get fired.
Oh, okay. You know what? That's when you just collect state unemployment.
I know, especially when you have a federal job or a government job.
Yeah, which technically we do, right?
Yeah. Ouch. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's I work for the government. Okay, let's see here. Boop, 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 boop. Hi, guys. Grilled cheese bake-off. We could do that. We could do that. I don't know. I just had such, like, I don't know. Do we want to talk about O.J. Simpson's death online? Otherwise, I'll save my what I'm about to say.
No, we're not going to talk about it on the
Okay,
air.
Let me just say this. I don't know. Like, I get it that I don't know if he did it or not. I think either A, he did it, or B, allegedly, he covered up for his son that did it. That's a conspiracy theory that I'm like, I can get behind that. But the conspiracy theory I 100% believe is that he is Khloe Kardashian's dad. Biologically, but like Robert Kardashian raised that girl.
If you say so.
But I don't know. I just think it's kind of, I don't know.
I just don't think he's really worth my time.
And like, well, I just think when it comes to like death, people can get a little funky about it. When I went to tour the prison this weekend, Jake, like what really, it was enjoyable. I love seeing that. But like, it was a little morbid to me when we went to the gas chamber and people were like posing in the chairs that people, like human beings, actually died in. And I get, they're murderers. They're not good people.
Wait, people died in a gas chamber?
Yes. Like they were killed. That's how they were killed, was by lethal gas.
Somebody killed them?
Yeah, because it was a prison.
Oh, what? So,
yeah.
They do that in prison?
Yeah, in Jefferson City. Back in like...
Jefferson City?
Jefferson City, Iowa. Missouri. Jefferson City, Missouri. Sorry. But like...
Oh my God, look. Look at this.
Oh no, that's too
She's
much.
She's on top of all the trash.
Oh, that's so sad. Moral of the story is I think it's a little weird that everyone sat in those chairs and like took pictures and like pretended to be dead
that.
And
Chicken.
Stuff.
It's still there. It's
too much for me. You guys can't see it. Jake's watching Hoarders. Brian, I'm glad that Kyla liked her birthday wishes.
Imagine that's your bedroom.
I honestly, hoarding really makes me anxious. Like, I can't watch these shows.
He's living in his yard.
Hoarders in my 600-pound life.
Poor guy.
Oh, see, it breaks my heart. I can't do that. Because, like, there's obviously something going on mentally with him that happened that made him feel like he can't give things up.
His wife left him, probably.
Or his wife passed, or his parents
didn't
love
him.
His wife
left him, probably cheated on him, and then he's left with the bag.
And see, and that's exactly it. Like, it's just kind of sad to me. I just, ugh.
Okay. Uh-oh. What?
What? You want to send me the prep when you have a chance? Chelsea, I'm glad that you liked it. It made me laugh. It made me laugh really hard.
What?
The seal video in my stories. Did you see it?
Like seal, like never gonna survive unless.
That's a great.
We get a little crazy.
That's a great seal
crazy
song.
Are the people walking down the stairs, pushing other ones.
Eyes become
What if I told you that the audio you're about to listen to is not from a human speaking, but a seal?
That's stupid.
Yeah,
that's
I know.
Stupid.
Look at what about this one? It's a little Frenchie trying to bite the tongue off of old sleeping bulldog.
Rude.
So my friend Andy and his wife JC, they have a basset hound that is a year old. She's big. I didn't realize. No, not basset hound. Bloodhound?
Oh, bloodhound?
Bloodhound gang? I don't know. Is there a difference?
Yes, there's a huge difference.
What's the big one?
Mostly gravity. The big one's a bloodhound.
Okay, it's a bloodhound then. But this is her as a baby. Look at that.
That's a basset hound.
That's a basset?
Yeah.
She's big and she's going to get bigger. She's like this big.
Show me a current picture and stop being so judgmental.
Okay. Let me see. Otherwise, I'll have him send me one. From Turf Twins.
Turf Twins?
Turf Twins. Dagus, where you at?
Dagus?
There you are.
What is going on here? Oh my God. Is this really called MILF Manor?
Ugh. Do you not know about MILF Manor?
Well, no, and I apparently am aware of MILF Manor 2, which is going to start soon. Seeking Sister Wife? What the
heck? Oh my gosh. That show, insanity. I'll keep up to it. I'll keep up with it for you. Okay, they don't have one. I'll just ask him for a current picture of her. Oh, there she is. She's playing with a toy.
She's not big. Stop it.
Oh, she's big. She is this long.
She's not that long.
She's that long. I'm not kidding. She's as long as their big dog. Like their chocolate lab. She's as long, but like this close to the ground. And her paws are huge. She's adorable. I love her, but she big. Like she jumped up. When she jumped up, Jake, her head was right here and I was able to do this.
Yeah.
Yeah. She a baby. And I said, your body's too big for your legs. Anyway, hi guys. I'm glad that I could help Chelsea wake up with Seal and good times.
Oh, we got a for a thought in 2 minutes.
What were you talking about?
It's on there.
You haven't sent me the prop.
I know, that's what I just realized.
Hey, hey, Chris.
So yeah. Give me reason to punch my face over and over. Oh my gosh, look at the sundogs.
Sundogs.
In the camera though. Oh my god, traffic, you suck.
We're trying to set up a Can I Pay That Dog tour, so we're going south.
Do you see what we're doing?
Did you share it? There it is.
Yeah, buddy, I did.
Hey.
Stop accusing me.
I'm not.
Before you accuse me, take a look at yourself.
Do you want me to do pop quiz today?
It is... No,
I don't. Oh, you got it?
I think so, but you're going to have to not click on one specific thing on the prep.
Well, you better tell me so I don't. Morning, Phil.
Don't click on the top one.
Okay. Oh, yes. Okay, I like that on your 720. I like this. This isn't for topics or for radio because it's past, but a library made a goof giving out counterfeit eclipse glasses.
Yeah, what the hell?
That could cause blindness.
Let's talk about that at 7:25 after traffic.
Oh, okay.
Let's put that after traffic because I saw that and I was like, I thought that was a little bit, like, dude, that's a major lawsuit.
Yeah.
But I think in turn, the blame goes to the people that sold it.
Yeah.
.89.7 The River Music from Sleep Theory at 7:27 on the Morning Fiasco with Jake and Elise. You're really concerned that your stuff is all dirty over there, aren't you?
Wow, Jake, don't call me out like that.
I just saw you put your headphones on and you looked at him like with the crusty eyes.
Okay. Listen, okay. When I've been on tour. I know how rare it is to get a shower.
Tell people what happened yesterday.
Oh, well, hey, we had a band in the studio. And it is up on YouTube.com, and they were... Yes,
the Driver Era.
That's right.
Played at Steelhouse Omaha last night, stopped by to see Corey yesterday, and when people come in the studio, we don't have a bunch of extra headphones laying around, right? Right. And so I allowed mine. I put yours out.
Yep.
Like, I said it all. I knew they were coming in, so I laid everything out because Corey's got enough to do coming
absolutely.
In, right?
Absolutely. You helped out so much with that.
So I put them out, and now you just keep, like... It smells of Lysol in here, and I just saw you holding them open and looking at them like, is there any ear crust on these things?
Listen, they're not dirty people by any means. I am an over-germaphobe. I understand
They're already gone. You can talk about the Driver Era being tour crusty. It's okay.
It's just, listen, it doesn't matter how clean you are. Clean on tour is disgusting in real life. And that's just the way it goes. That van or their bus or whatever does not have a working shower. They never do.
Hey, when you're on tour, do you go out to eat a lot or do you get groceries and try to save money?
Groceries and save money.
Okay, that's what you try.
Unless it's Taco Bell, baby.
Then, okay, I won't say anything about that. There's research that's been done, okay, that when you go grocery shopping, mm-hmm. do you go grocery shopping like right after a meal or do you go grocery shopping to cook the meal?
Ooh, it depends, but I don't like to go on an empty stomach.
Okay.
Yeah.
And why is that? Because you'll be tempted by things?
Because
they've got an olive bar. I need some olives.
I tend to buy more treats if I go grocery shopping hungry.
Do you ever go grocery shopping and then eat what you buy on the way home?
Yesterday I did because I got chopped up watermelon and I was starving. So I ate that.
Okay.
Yeah.
This research shows that if you do not eat before you go.
Mm-hmm.
To the grocery store, you spend an average of $26 more than you spend if you go on a full stomach.
Right now, that's like a gallon of milk in a frozen pizza.
Yes, that's exactly. It's your meal for the night. The Tostino's party pizza for $15 and a $9 gallon of milk.
That makes sense, though. Do you go grocery shopping on a empty stomach or full stomach?
I'll be honest. I don't go grocery shopping because Michelle does all the grocery shopping.
Yeah.
So she does all the grocery shopping. And the only shopping I do, really, is when we go to Costco.
And they have samples.
Yeah, but no, I don't delve in the samples.
Every
once in a while, but I don't. Largely, I'll avoid them.
Yeah.
But the problem is that when we go to Costco, we get things for the duration, and then it's also on the way home is our favorite Chinese food restaurant.
Oh, see, that's perfect though.
Yeah, but then you're spending X amount of dollars at Costco, and then you throw another $30 in there for three people at Chinese food.
Like, yeah, but you put the effort in to get the food. And that's tomorrow's food. That's tomorrow and this week's food. On the way home, you get Din Din.
Okay.
You already did the adult thing. Treat yourself.
Okay. All right. Well.
Financial advice from Elise Hall.
76% of people agree that they're more likely to spend more if they shop while hungry. About 60% say they're likely to buy more unhealthy foods, which is what you do. The research also found that the average person makes 2 grocery runs per week and budgets $162 for their haul. Although that's kind of vague because they don't break down how that may change depending on the size of the household and the area of the country that you live in, things like that.
I was going to say, compared to the coasts, our groceries are fairly cheap, even though they're freaking expensive right now. But my sister has 2 teenage boys and a girl that's an Irish dancer. And so between her husband, and the problem is they eat so healthy. My sister's completely paleo. She has been for like almost over a decade.
Mm-hmm.
And her kids eat like that, and her husband eats like that.
Mm-hmm.
And so their grocery bill, I think I she told my dad that they spend $2,500 a month on groceries.
Holy smokes.
Yeah. And that's and they already have all the meat for the year.
Yeah, because they buy it in bulk from the farmer.
Yeah, exactly. So, okay. Oof. So all right. But the moral of the story?
Eat before you go to the store and make sure that you take out that personal loan before you go as well.
Ugh.
It smells like campfire in here now, too.
Is it me? I don't think it's me.
No, it's literally coming in from outside. Is it smoky outside?
I didn't notice it, but I'm not very observant, to be honest.
Go! All right, you got the spray?
You got it. Yeah, it is smoky in here.
Yep, sure is.
So, how bad were the campfires last night then? Or the wildfires last night?
The wind was so extreme that they couldn't get it out.
Oh, that's tough. God bless the firefighters. The Thick New World Festival. Let's just go into automatic. Automatic's our friend.
Throw that in auto and come here.
He told me to throw it in auto. Ooh, I don't like the way that I read this. August 2nd at the Admiral. Chris, where are you located? When you say here, because like yesterday, man, my mom was telling me that, so my mom's a really big into genealogy and like history and stuff. And if you ever see the house that I grew up in, like my family farm and stuff, people like, it's crazy. Like it's very historically oriented, but she was telling me that people actually went crazy from the wind, like settlers. 89, 7 the River, what's up? Just two people. Is this Russ? Russ, Jake, Russ says you're insane. What Chinese food are you eating at where three people eat for $30?
Ming's.
Oh, he doubled down too. He was confident in that. It was $30.
I can tell you exactly what we get. We get, and it's $32.
It's $32. Wow.
Maybe stop eating at the expensive Chinese food places, Mr.
Wow.
West
now
Omaha.
He's attacking your character. And he's saying maybe you should stop eating at the expensive Chinese food places.
Did you throw in Mr. West Omaha?
Yeah, you got to limit, man. My rule for Chinese food places is if it looks a little sketchy, that's the best place to eat. That's the one to go to. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, you don't like that sodium and MSG.
He doesn't like vegetables.
Oh, well, that makes sense. All right, well, Russ, it was a pleasure. We got to talk here in 10. Bye. I adore Russ.
$7.35 here on the Fiasco, and finally, frickin' Friday, the old Triple F, baby. This is what we're looking at as far as the weather today goes. High of 68. Sunny skies that will continue through the weekend. Highs increasing into the mid to upper 80s. 83 tomorrow. And apparently it's National Mow Your Lawn for the First Time week. That's what's going on. Right now at the River Studios, a beautiful day has started. And we are already up and out at the tune of 39 degrees.
Ooh. It's getting nice this weekend.
Yeah, it is getting nice. Absolutely. The clouds not there, which some of the places in the United States were there for the eclipse on Monday.
Mm-hmm.
You and I both saw this story that a library in New Jersey gave out free glasses. They bought some glasses. They went to WallyWorld.com. And started, they're like, hey, come get your eclipse glasses. And people were like, hey, this is great. Now we can watch the eclipse ourselves. And guess what? They were counterfeit.
It's not the place to cut corners.
Yeah. Especially if you're a place that depends on people having eyes to be able to read.
Yeah.
Unless they had a large Braille collection, and then maybe that's where they were going with it.
They accidentally ordered a lot of Braille.
They found out before the event, barely, that the glasses were fake, and sent out an urgent Facebook message and said, do not use the eclipse glasses we gave you. So they avoided, at least according to this, they got through to everybody that had grabbed the glasses from the library.
Well, I mean, how many people are going to the library nowadays?
Well, I mean, just a couple.
Like 6 or 7?
Yeah.
Yeah, they probably had them. They had their library cards and everything.
The people were probably there on Facebook there. That's why they go to the library, to use the internet.
Ugh, you guys also, let's patron our libraries. We need those.
Unless you're looking for Braille, and then you're going to need somebody to help you, okay? Kings of Leon now. It's called Mustang. It's new on the river.
Libraries are disappearing.
They are.
Let's not have that happen. Ooh, David, you think Three Happiness is the best Chinese, huh? I don't really have a favorite place anymore. It used to be Rice Bowl. Oh, David, I know the area you live in then. I've been to that library many a time. The library in North Bend, they built a new one a little north of town. And the old library, it was a Carnegie library. And so the person that bought it turned it into their residence. And I would love to go in there. I loved the smell of libraries, kind of those old books and stuff. My mom is a librarian, so. Sarah, I think I order from China Walk a lot. It's either China Walk or Panda House, and Panda House is at like 100 and...
Sarah should know about Ming's. She's from Papillion.
44th. Do you know about... Yeah, I think you said something about Ming's above. I haven't been to the Fremont one since they updated it now. Yeah, I could see Glenwood not having a Chinese restaurant. I feel like Glenwood isn't like a huge town. It's not tiny, but it's not huge. Oh, Glenwood does have one. Okay, okay. Oh, here's another RV for sale in 1994.
Did we not do traffic?
We did.
Did we just not seriously just cruise through not doing traffic?
We did weather. Yeah.
What an idiot. That's what happens when I'm out there trying to figure out where the...
Where the Smokies is coming from?
Yeah.
Bye, Chris. Have a really good day. Oh, I'm sorry you didn't sleep last night. Hopefully you can get some Z's in now. My Menards app just opened for some reason. I wonder what it's trying to tell me. There is an app for Menards. Yes, ma'am. That's where I do a lot of my online shopping when I need something. Especially this summer, I'm going to need a lot. I got three projects. I've got, number one, we're going to build my tiny house. Number two, we're going to restore and preserve the altars at my parents' church. And then number three is we're gonna see what we can do with Bonita. She's going to be a good learning car because I don't really know anything about mechanics. So I think she's going to be an easy one. Not an easy one, but like she'll be a fun one to learn mechanic stuff on. Oh, I know you do, Jakob. I spent basically my entire childhood. Anytime I go out with my dad somewhere, he'd take me to either Millard Lumber or Christensen Lumber. So the old Millard Lumber area, very familiar with. It's kind of weird that it's turned into what it is now. It's all like upscale and stuff. But yeah, Jakob, I'll let you know if I need anything. Ooh, Devi got to sleep in a little bit. Aaliyah, you forgot about my nards? David is yelling, "Hey Jake, how are you doing over there?"
I'm all right. How are you guys?
.89.7 The River Music from Imagine Dragons at 7:44. Good morning. It's finally frickin' Friday. How are we doing today? So good, in fact, that I did not tell you that there is an accident on I-480 southbound onto the JFK. So heads up there, left lane blocked there. Accident left lane blocked as well. I-680 southbound after Maple and I-29 northbound and southbound between 16th Street and I-680 exit 61. Is closed both left lanes both ways. So just a heads up there that you will need to move over to the right. It is finally freaking Friday. Elise,
what's
the plan for the weekend?
Oh, I'm going to go out to the farm. I'm going to start one of my many projects. I got some shirts to finish up for Through Fire. And then
what project are you going to start on? Have you decided yet?
Oh, gosh, I don't know. I've got three of them. I'm going to build a tiny house. I'm helping restore the altars at my parents' church. I got Bonita, so okay,
but
I don't know.
But pick one.
Okay, let's go with a tiny house.
Okay, tiny house it is.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, we'll start that. We'll see how it goes. We'll pour the foundation this weekend.
Pour a foundation?
Yeah, I got to pour a foundation. Well, I got to pour a pad because it's going to be movable. I might sell it at the end.
Where are you going to get the concrete at?
Oh, my dad has a concrete maker.
Jesus.
Mixer.
This guy's got everything, just like Seven Dust does in this song. Music from Seven Dust. We'll hear from Five Finger Death Punch coming up. Don't forget, before the show is over today, we have got a chance for you to get in on those Win It Before You Can Buy It's for Blue October.
Woo!
Along with Switchfoot, Matt Nathanson at Pinewood Bowl Theater, okay? Pimp Your Patio qualifications, chance for that coming up as well. It's 89.7 The River. I mean, this guy lives in a junkyard.
He lives in a junkyard? Aww.
Pretty much, yes. They bring in a professional organizer for what? What exactly are you going to organize here? It's all trash.
The chaos?
It's all outside. It's all trash.
Ugh.
Ugh.
Man, I don't know. It just makes me so sad for them.
It goes to the shed. Look at the shed.
Like, that's an old refrigerating unit. They don't need that. I mean, yeah, you could probably... Yeah, okay. So they're gathering for scrap metal.
Yeah. 8 tons of scrap metal? That's a lot.
It's a lot of scrap metal.
I mean, there's shelves that he's not using. Like, all that stuff in there.
I did learn that from the tow guy... that you cannot take RVs to scrap yards. You can't scrap them. You have to, like, rip everything out of the inside before you even take them in.
Okay, I already talked about fart walks.
Ew.
We talked about National Groceries Day, grocery shopping. What else?
Oh, let's see here.
We talked about the library. Some stupid news highlights.
Let's see.
Oh, we can talk about tax day.
Ugh, yeah, that's coming up.
On Monday.
I need to double check on my taxes. I got Nebraska and federal done like early. Yeah. But when I got them done, apparently Iowa hadn't finalized some laws or whatever. So I wasn't able to finish my Iowa ones yet. So I have to go back and finish that up. So, yay.
Okay, let's talk about taxes. There's a story on the Stupid News Plus.
Okay.
Yeah, it's number 12. There's a rake.
Well, that could come in handy.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. A woman left a $1,000 tip at a taco restaurant in Florida because she thought she was going to be swept up in the biblical rapture on the day of the eclipse, and she wasn't. Now she wants a refund. I'm sorry. You don't get a refund.
If you're going to join the kookiness, then you get your kooky taken.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, okay. Everything lined up for it. I saw this video, and it was like just making all these connections. It was on the final day of the octave of Easter. I get it. However, use your effing brain. Use your brain. Use your brain. This world ended in 2012 anyway.
Wow.
I mean, that's the conspiracy, not conspiracy theory, but that's like one of those theories out there that the world actually ended in 2012. We just got sucked into a black hole because that's when they started up the Hadron Collider and it created a black hole that everything's just been swept into. I'm just vibing though. I think people put too much stock into things. It's going to end when it's going to end. Oh, Monday's your grandson's fourth birthday. Oh, that's a great age. They're so cute at that age.
Volkswagen Bug has been there so long they have to dig it out of the ground.
Wow. Ooh, someone might want to body that, actually. That's kind of a cool car. Oh, he's mad. Of course he's mad. He doesn't want to give it up.
They're taking the cars and they're taking them. They're not giving any money in for them. They're just taking them.
I don't like
they're
that.
They're not going to tow it unless they get to keep it. This is why nobody's coming into my house to take my stuff.
Yeah. That's a shame, though, because those bodies can actually go for, like, at least a couple grand. Mayan calendar. Oh, that's right. It ended in 2012 or whatever. What?
Is this really the... So Five Finger Death Punch and Blue October are the same night. Not that they're going to clash, but it's just funny.
I think that's kind of perfect, actually. If there were two shows on the same night, yeah, that's perfect. Who, Five Finger?
Yeah, Marilyn Manson and who?
Slaughter to Prevail.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Oh, actually, no. This is going to be tough. No, it's not. I'll go to Slaughter to Prevail. I'll leave early, head to Blue October.
Ridiculous. I'm over and under it.
I'm under and over it.
You got, what are all the pre-sales today, or all the on-sales today?
Well, let's see here. Good morning, Rick Barr.
Hey, find the pre-sales today so we can talk about that real quick.
I don't
quick.
Even know where to find those. Okay,
sorry.
89.7 The River.
It's 89.7 The River. Music from Five Finger Death Punch there with Over and Under It. No, Under and Over It. That's the only way you can make the... You got to go over it if you're talking about toilet paper. If you're talking about the Five Finger Death Punch song, it's Under and Over It.
Okay? That's right.
Yeah.
That is right.
I don't trust people that put the toilet paper the wrong way.
I don't either. Mm-mm. The patent came out and everything, the original patent, and it's over it.
Yes.
Come on now.
I just don't get it. I just don't get it at all. Yeah. Good morning. It's the Morning Fiasco at 7:54 as we head into another beautiful day, 68 for your high sunny skies. And, of course, we sit right now around the 40-degree mark here at the River Studios, getting warmer rapidly as the beautiful sunrise began the day today. By the way, Five Finger Death Punch, August 21st, CHI Health Center, Omaha. A couple other bands opening on that bill. And this is a big day. Fridays are, because 10 a.m. is when the shows become available. Not only are we making our show, the River Summer Bash, available at 10 a.m., the public on sale. That is, of course, Offspring, Safe Ferris, The Urge, and Straight Jacket on July 23rd at the Astro. But also Blue October is on sale at 10. Iowa is for Lovers. Is that one of the other ones that's on sale this morning?
I do believe so. My okay. computer has gone ahead and yep. frozen. However, oh. you can go to 897theriver.com. You have all the information there.
Yeah.
And
don't forget all the shows that are available this morning at 10 a.m. In addition to all the other ones that are already out there. You can see everything on our concerts and events page at 897theriver.com. Tax day on Monday. A lot mm-hmm. of people buy concert tickets with their tax refunds. And here are some steps if you have not yet filed yours. First of all, why not? What are you waiting for? So if you need an extension for perhaps, you can request one. If you're not going to make the Monday deadline, you can apply for an extension. Your request must be filed by Monday, and it doesn't give you an extension of time for payment if you owe money. So remember that. If you need an extension, just ask for one. They'll give you one, but get those taxes filed quick. Get organized as well. A lot of people, as soon as they get all their W-2s and everything else that they need, put it into a documents list. Obviously, you can upload those is the way to do it most days, but you can find out what you need on the IRS website at irs.gov, and you can file e-files the fastest way to go. Obviously, that's been around for years, and you can free file through the IRS free file. That link is available on the IRS website as well. So again, irs.gov. And the final thing is file even if you miss the deadline. If you haven't filed your taxes by the 15th, still complete your return as soon as possible. The penalty for a late filing is a percentage of the taxes that you didn't pay on time. There's no penalty being late if you're owed a refund, but you still do need to get that taken care of, okay?
Yeah. And if you owe in, get on a payment plan. It's not that big of a deal.
Yeah, they'll help you figure it out. I mean, you're not going to go to jail right away.
Yeah.
But you know, you can, I mean, if you have a hole and you have a shovel and choose to keep digging, I mean, that's on you, my friend. That's on you. Tax day coming Monday. So get those taxes in by the deadline. Make sure they're postmarked and mailed and emailed and all that jazz by then, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's our public service message for today.
I sent you an audio to play at the end of birthdays.
Okay. What were we gonna do after 7:50?
Let me look. Prep is not very good today.
Oh, I know it was.
Okay, good.
I mean, this is just trash. Just got trash. It's just trash. It just needs to be thrown away.
Yeah.
Oh, look, they cleared that whole backyard up.
Ooh, Allie, you're wearing your Camp Crystal Lake. That's pretty awesome. I'm glad to hear that. Rick Barnes, you're in Sioux Falls. What are you doing in Sioux Falls?
Rick Barnes.
Rick Barnes.
Is he working?
I don't know. Phil, where are they playing tomorrow? Nonpoint Head P. Is that the Bourbon with Dropout Kings? Lori, to answer your question, we're still working out some stuff. So pay attention. We don't have anything official to say yet, just because we're still working on some stuff.
He just told his kids that he's got cancer all through his body.
That's tough.
Yeah, buddy.
Oh, it's tomorrow? Okay. Head P is tomorrow. Head P. Nonpoint. Dropout Kings.
Where? In Lincoln?
In Lincoln. I think I'm guessing the Bourbon.
All right. Remember to
try. Oh, it is Bourbon. Okay. Okay. What?
Straight up 8 a.m. Here we go with your traffic report on this beautiful Friday. Finally, frickin' Friday. And let's go to the cams, looking at the normal things. And it includes accidents posted throughout. And here they are. Accident left lane blocked. I-680 southbound right after Maple Street. So in between Maple and Dodge, stop and go traffic back to Fort Street right now. And an accident on the left shoulder of JFK 75 southbound. That is creating issues just on a tiny bit on 480 onto that on-ramp, and also I-80 is clear because it is not in that area. So if you're on I-80 going to 75 southbound, you're good to go. If you're on I-480 going southbound JFK, that's when you'll have to move over to the right couple of emergency vehicles in the lanes there. Dodge westbound, slow between 108th and 120th. And taking a look at Dodge eastbound, all good as far as that is. So that's your traffic check. Just after 8 o'clock here on the Morning Fiasco. Weather again, perfect today. 68 sunny. The wind has gone down quite a bit, just 8 to 10. Yeah, we'll see some gusts around 16, so maybe save the fire pit for another day. Over the weekend, the winds will continue to get a little bit more, and then by the time we hit Tuesday, they will blow in some weather for you, some thunderstorms in the forecast for Tuesday, but Saturday, Sunday, Monday, sunny, 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 including today. So enjoy that. Should be great, okay?
I like it.
Even late. There is a woman that was on Zoom. There has been a lot of women and men on Zoom as of late, right? Mm-hmm. It's a new thing. It's a new way to communicate. Are you a Zoom meeting kind of person?
I'd rather not be, but yeah, I'll do it.
If you have to.
If I have to, I will.
Yeah, I don't need to be on Zoom. I would rather just have a phone call or whatever it is, right?
Just FaceTime me. Just get an iPhone and FaceTime me.
No, you're not going to do that. A woman is going viral because during her Zoom meeting at her house, at her home, she placed her dog's water bowl very, very closely to her computer desk, right? Because she loves her animals. She wants them close by.
Mm-hmm.
But here's the way that sounded.
He's just a thirsty guy.
You're hearing my dog.
So yeah, so she made it clear that she wasn't drinking out of a bowl herself. She's hearing the dog. Now, a lot of people hear that. Sometimes if you've got a dog that you have a water bowl overnight, you will hear that overnight.
Yeah, yeah.
What does that sound? Like, Stevie, that's enough. Stop drinking so much. yeah, and then if you walk into it, that's the worst part.
When it's all just sloppy everywhere.
Yeah, you just sleep.
And then you know that you're going to have to wake up in an hour to take them outside.
That's right.
That's the worst part. That's
exactly what it is. So anyway, there's another PSA for you today. Don't put your dog's water bowl by your Zoom camera microphone. Otherwise, you'll have some splaining to do.
Man, so many birthdays today.
All right, let's do this pop quiz.
Birthdays are done. Honestly, we could probably, that audio I sent you, we could probably play that in the background during birthdays.
Friend, where did you send it?
I thought you wanted it
on birthdays.
Yeah, I said play it after birthdays, but playing it during birthdays might be the move. Where do you want me to send it? Let's see here.
I have to log in regardless. It doesn't matter.
Oh, I'll send it to, let's see here. Which one's this? You know what? I'll send it to all the Jake Ryans.
Just send it to Reaver Jake.
Reaver Jake?
Yeah, don't send it to all of them because then I have to delete all of them.
I think I sent it to Reaver Jake. I'm not sure. Okay, just kidding then. There you go. Oh! Big stretch.
Is it his birthday today?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. When I was brushing my teeth this morning, it just felt like extra good. Do you ever have those mornings where brushing your teeth just feels extra good? You're just like, ugh.
Get all the fur off of them.
Get that fur off of them. Ew. I hate that. If you're ever having a bad mental day, brush your teeth and take a shower. It will help. As hard as it sounds to do, yeah.
But it's all right. Easy for you to say.
A97 River, what's up? Good morning, who is this? Well, hi, what can we do for you? Are you just calling to say hi? Yeah. How old are you, Calvin? Now, do you not have school today? No? Well, what are you going to do today? The Luminarium, that's so cool. Have you ever been before? Yeah, it's so cool, isn't it? Yeah, well, that sounds like a good day. Yeah, those are pretty fun. Yeah.
What the fuck?
Does it?
What the fuck is going on?
Oh, I gotcha. Well, you sound... Go ahead. Oh, you too, Calvin. Have fun today. Okay, but bye. That was David called in with Calvin. I'm pretty sure that's what that was.
That's what it was.
My heart is warmed. Also, David, wait a parent and get him comfortable on the phone. 10 out of 10 on that one. Ooh, Phil, good for you. Oh, Calvin, what a sweetie pie. Oh, that's kind of fun. On Wednesday, it was National Siblings Day, and Josh and Bo Naylor, who are of the Cleveland Guardians,
yep, hit a home run.
They both hit home runs. That is so special. Their parents were so excited for them. It's my dad's team.
What do you want to talk about here in a minute and a half?
I'm trying to find something here.
Pick something easy.
Oh, I got one. All right.
Okay. Sounds good. I'm looking forward to it.
Excellent.
Okay. Can I lead you into it at all?
Maybe.
Well, you got 9 seconds.
Okay, then. No, okay. I'll get us there.
Okay. All right, here we go. 89.7 The River, Michael Marchese with Scared to Start. It's one of those TikTok hits, and it has permeated your airwaves here at The River. We, of course, we'd like to be first, but sometimes we'll take some tips as far as that goes. And that's a nice mellow tune for the morning. The guy's going to be a hit. He actually was at a show at the Slowdown opening up two months ago, I believe. Sophia went and took it all in.
Oh, wow. Yeah, so that's nice.
It is finally frickin' Friday on the Morning Fiasco. Hopefully you are good today as we get through our final work day of the week.
Absolutely. It's supposed to be really nice out this weekend. Mm-hmm. We got highs of 70s all weekend, including today.
Mid-80s, baby.
Mid-80s. Whoo, yeah. Just kidding then. Yeah. So have you been to San Francisco?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's oftentimes not that warm there.
It's not that warm. It is right off the bay there, so it is freezing there. So a tow truck driver tried to tow someone.
Mm-hmm. That's not unusual.
But they were at a stoplight. So
their car break down there?
No, their car did not break down there. Okay.
They were in an accident.
So, no. Okay, so here's the scoop. Here's what happened. And if you want, on 89, or if you go to youtube.com, 89.7 The River, I'm playing the video for you right now. So basically, in San Francisco, there is this tow company, and apparently they have been illegally towing cars and holding them for ransom. So everything came to a head yesterday when someone in San Francisco got footage of a tow truck driver trying to tow the car at a stoplight with two people inside of it. So they were just there, and they had to back up, and they were trying to get away from this. And the guy's like backing up, trying to lock their wheels in. And again, if you want to see it, youtube.com, 89.7 The River. These two people are trying to get away. The company is called Specialty Towing. And so they would just find legally parked cars.
Yeah.
And tried to tow them, and then they would just hold him for ransom.
Really? And that's weird. Oh, yeah. Like, he peels away after a
ransom. And then he peels away when he can't do it. I've been to San Francisco. Those streets are busy the majority of the time, so the fact that this car could back up, the car is backing up, trying to get away.
How has this tow company not been, like, arrested? How have they not been shut down?
Well, apparently it's never been caught on video, and so the city has been siding with this tow company, saying, well, if they towed you, you probably did something wrong. And everyone's like, no, I was parked legally, here's where I was.
And they've gone from legally parked cars
to cars in intersections.
That apparently, yes, cars in intersections, and then they just peel away. I don't understand this, the unhingedness of this. So San Francisco came out and they said, no, we went ahead and canceled all our contracts with them earlier this year. They'd been illegally doing this. I don't know how nobody's pressed charges.
Yeah, that's super weird.
Have you ever had anything weird like that happen?
No. That's some GTA stuff right there.
That is some GTA stuff.
Those drivers have been playing too many video games and probably lucky you didn't get out and you know, try to beat you with a lead pipe or whatever.
Seriously. Now, I will say San Francisco's gotten a little weird, okay? Like, it's weird there now, but this is one of the weirdest things I've seen come out of there.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Okay. Man. Well, welcome to third world San Francisco.
San Francisco.
I mean, that doesn't... Like, how crazy is that?
That's insanity.
You're literally sitting there and they just back up and start, oh, I'll just tell you.
What do you even do?
I don't know. It's like, that's like being mugged on the street. That's what it is.
You're being mugged, yeah.
Yeah.
Man.
Okay.
Well, there you go.
Music from Good Neighbors coming up. We will hear this one from Pearl Jam. It's Yellow Ledbetter. It's on 89.7 The River. Good morning. On the ceiling.
Oh, shoot.
Why is I wanna say
there we go. Limited it down. Yeah, I know, Phil. I'd get out and fight. I would get out and fight. But it's San Francisco. I don't think it's smart to get out and fight in San Francisco. When I was last in San Francisco, this is, I feel like, the perfect summing up of what San Francisco really is. This homeless guy came up to me and asked for money, and I gave him like $5 or whatever. And then he proceeded to hit on me. So that was a situation. That was an interesting situation. Oh my gosh, David, I saw that. So David says, why am I not surprised that I opened Hulu this morning and the first thing advertised is People vs. OJ series on Netflix a few years ago? Yeah. I saw that last night and I'm like, I don't know, man. That seems in a... poor taste. I don't know how to feel about it. How do you guys feel about it? Because it's like a human died. Technically, he was exonerated with the legal system. was he exonerated or was he just released? Do you guys think he did it? Do you guys think OJ did it? That's my question.
Hey, what would you like to do at 8:20?
8:20. That's fine. Oh, interesting. The reason that there's a top 40 songs is because jukeboxes in the 50s could only hold 40 songs. Crazy. Let's look at yesterday's. I feel like yesterday's was on fire.
What's in stupid news?
Not much. I looked there too.
How about the bakery that's asking people to look for their lost diamond?
Oh, sure. That's crazy. I like that.
How about the tip? How about the $1,000 tip?
Oh yeah, I guess we could talk about that too.
Or we could do the bakery in Kansas.
Which one would
$4,000 diamond?
Which one would you like $4,000 diamond? Let's see, what would that be? That would probably be like a 1 carat. Where's that one at? Kansas?
Yeah.
Well, that's close to home. Let's do that.
Why don't you send that $1,000 tip thing to Corey?
You got it.
I looked down at my hand and the center diamond is gone, banging the bowls and the pans. But we kind of went back to the kitchen and looked around. I was crying and all he could say is, "You still have me." That made it all better. It's 36 years on this hand, but I would definitely make it worth your while bringing it back.
That's why you take your jewelry off when you do baking.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it looks like a small business, though. I don't want to, like, you know, blame or anything. Phil, that's fair. That's fair. I asked them while you were gone, I'm like, do you think he did it? OJ Simpson or whatever. And Phil goes, football legend, hate him more for bringing the Kardashians into the world and allegedly what happened to Nicole. Fair. He is the reason that.
I don't care.
The Kardashians are, I mean, he's a big reason why.
.89.7 The River, the anchor for alternative and rock. It's Good Neighbors with the track called Home at 8:22. Good morning. It's finally freaking Friday.
Hi. How's it going?
What she meant was high of 68 today. Beautiful sunny skies. Mid-80s tomorrow, Sunday and Monday. And some thunderstorms in the forecast for Tuesday night. So that's good. That's good.
Excellent.
You know what's not good? When you're chewing and you crunch on something that's hard, right?
Like, ooh, never good.
Get a piece of gravel in your burger. Mm. I mean, just, you know, popcorn kernels.
Yeah.
Diamonds in your cut chocolate chip cookies.
No.
Have you?
What's that one?
Have you been to Leavenworth recently?
Actually, yes.
Not the penitentiary, the actual town?
No, not the penitentiary. The town, yes, actually, yeah. I have.
Leavenworth, Kansas is the site of Sis's Sweet Cookies and Cafe. Longtime owner, Don Sis Monroe. Says, hey, if you bought anything from me recently, could you please be careful when you're chewing? And if you find my $4,000 diamond from my ring, please, please, please let me know. She lost her diamond ring while baking. I don't know. Maybe take your ring off, right?
Oh, yeah.
This is what Sis has said to all those that may have shopped at her shop.
I looked down at my hand and the center diamond is gone, banging the bowls and the pans. So we kind of went back to the kitchen and looked around. I was crying and all he could say is, you still have me. It's 36 years on this hand. So I would definitely make it worth your while bringing it back.
All right, there you go. She lost her center cut diamond into, she thinks, she's not sure. I mean, just like Jerry Cantrell, he thought he had his guitar had been stolen. It was just misplaced. Maybe she just misplaced her ring.
She might have, but I feel like this is a great time to, ladies, if you have your diamond ring, make sure you get your prongs checked. Like, normally wherever your husband bought it from, unless he bought it from an independent jeweler, like, you can take it back there, get your prongs checked, because that diamond can fall out anywhere.
Right, you just, you know, get your mammogram and get your prongs checked. I mean,
yeah. Also,
all the things you should do as far as maintenance of your body and soul.
And make sure that you have your ring insured, because insurance will cover the diamond.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Oh, you guys. That's so sad for her, though.
Absolutely.
36 years.
Yep, yep. It was in the dough that was made last Friday, so a week ago. So if you have picked up cookies in the Leavenworth area at Sis's Bakery, you might have yourself a little jackpot on hand, right?
Yeah. Would you bring it back or would you just keep it?
Do you think she's going to provide reward money, or do you just be like, here's cakes for eternity?
I feel like it's going to be loaves of bread and cookies and cakes for eternity. Would you keep it or would you bring it back?
No. What I mean, yes, I would take it back.
I would take it back, especially if I got a free cookie out of it.
You'd probably get a whole dozen.
Absolutely.
Maybe even a baker's dozen. You'll get that extra one.
Oh, look at that. That's so sweet. Yeah, that's so sad. My mom, actually, she was washing her hands one time when I was really little, and her diamond, she saw it clink, clink, clink in the sink and went down the drain.
Did you get it out of the?
No, it didn't. No? Because it was at a school that she worked at.
And
she was a teacher.
Wasn't accessible
They got the trap and it wasn't there.
What?
So the janitor came, opened up the trap, and it wasn't there.
Just disappeared. Wow.
So, yeah, it's sad when that happens, but hopefully she has some contingencies, someone finds it, or it's insured.
And it might be, you might be a little uncomfortable, but always remember to have your prongs checked.
If anybody's ever had a ring, number one, insurance. Number two, keep it healthy. 897 The River, what's up? That's never a good idea. Toy, did she find it at least, though? She didn't eat the ring? Oh, my gosh. Well, that's... Don't... Okay, number one, I don't want anything in my food, period. Number two, I would probably be so hungry that it would be in my tummy at the end of it. And number three, under the plate was an excellent decision. 10 out of 10 on that. That's crazy. Crazy. Well, thanks for calling. It's a terrible idea. Don't put it in anything that you can ingest. That's my whole thing. No, that's a terrible idea. That's terrible and gross. Thank you so much for your call. Who is this? Marcus, terrible, gross. Well, you have a good day. Bye. Marcus was saying that he worked at a restaurant one time and the guy asked him to put the ring in the food. And
you'll lose it.
They put it underneath the plate, not in the food, which I'm like, I would prefer that.
Yeah.
And then the whole time the fiance thought that she ate it. And then when the waitress came and picked up the plate, it was right underneath there. Oh, Jacob said, I lost my diamond wedding ring years ago, took it off, washed my hands, and poof, it was gone. Oof.
Go!
Yeah, Ashley says, my main diamond broke and fell in a drain when I was cleaning them at work long time ago, old job. It was insured, but I didn't know I needed to bring it in once a month or however long to uphold. Yeah, because gold and silver are actually, like, especially gold, they're very, very, very malleable metals. And so they can break.
Okay, here we go. Your traffic at 8:29 on the Morning Fiasco on your beautiful Friday ahead of you. Looking like a beautiful Friday. Yeah, we got a small accident on the left shoulder of JFK southbound after I-80 eastbound, but that is not causing any issues other than if you're coming onto JFK from I-480. All right, if you're entering from 80 either way onto JFK southbound, you are good to go. If you're coming up from I-480 southbound onto that accident, move over to the right, you'll be good to go as that the emergency vehicles await you there. Other than that, things have cleared off this morning on our way to another beautiful day in the metro. Again, the accident, JFK southbound, the only thing that we've got to worry about as of right this moment. How about you, me, the 21st of August, go to Lincoln? Would you like me to drive? That way you and Jordan can have a few cocktails.
Oh, sounds like fun.
Okay. Is Jordan going to go to Blue October?
He would go for me.
He would go
for He would rather you. Go to Slaughter to Prevail that day.
Okay.
Yeah,
all right.
But I would.
Maybe you could do both.
Blue October. Yeah, we could do both.
Okay.
All yeah, right. Absolutely.
August 21st, Blue October, and Switchfoot, also Matt Nathanson on that bill, Pinewood Bowl Theater at Pioneers Park in Lincoln. We've got a pair of tickets for you. Remember, they don't even become available until 10 a.m., and you can hook yourself up right now. Got to be caller number 10, though, 712-328-8970, the number in. Blue October tickets are yours. If you're number 10, be lucky, my friend. Take a chance. Here's Blue October now on 89.7 The River. All right, we got to go quick because we got 3.5 minutes.
Caller one, try back. Caller two, try again. Caller three, try back. Caller four, try again. Caller five, try back. Caller six, try again.
Sounds good to me. Would you like to answer the phone?
Sure.
Okay. All right. Here we go. Ready? In 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead.
89.7 The River. Who's this?
Hey, this is Brian.
Brian, how's it going today?
Well, hopefully it's going great. It's going okay so far.
Well, it's
going
to go great because you're caller 10.
Woohoo.
You're in as number 10. You've got a pair of Blue October tickets before you can buy them. Brian, congratulations, my friend.
Hey, thank you, man.
All right, hold on 1 second, Brian.
Sure.
I got you.
Hand me that sheet.
I got you. Here.
Thank you.
Line twosie.
Hey, Brian, you still there? All right, what's your last name? Oh my gosh, you're the luckiest human being ever. You know what? Hey,
bye.
The universe has different plans for everyone. What's your phone number? Exactly. Okay, so what is your phone number? And what's your email? Perfect. All right. Well, you are in for Blue October happening August 22nd at the Pinewood Bowl. Winners will be emailed tickets, so keep an eye out for that a little closer to the date. They aren't in yet, so just keep an eye out in your email for those. Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Brian. Have a great day. Bye.
Okay, you ready?
Yes.
So we're just going to congratulate him. We'll come back with birthdays, okay? This is not birthdays.
You got it.
Okay. And he's going to say, thank you much. And then you say, hang on a second, Brian. Okay? That's when you bring the mics back.
You got it.
Okay. And I want you to answer the phone as well.
Live?
Yeah.
Here?
Okay. So we'll just, we'll set it up. I'll set it up and then point to you and say, 89.7 The River, who's this?
Okay.
Cool?
You got it.
Okay. And then I'll give you a count to the end. All right, here we go. 20 seconds. '89.7 The River. It's a sing-along with Blue October and Calling You off of the album Foiled way back when. 8:34, and we are looking for caller number 10.
89.7 The River. Who's this?
Hey, this is Brian.
Brian, how's it going today?
Well, hopefully it's going great. It's going okay so far.
Well, it's
going
to go great because you're caller 10.
Woohoo!
You're in as number 10. You've got a pair of Blue October tickets before you can buy them. Brian, congratulations, my friend.
Hey, thank you, man.
All right, hold on, Brian. Let's get some info from you.
All right, last pair of tickets. We just dished them out. Remember, the on sale begins at 10 a.m. They are available to the public at 10 a.m. The show August 21st with Blue October, Switchfoot, and Matt Nathanson out at Pinewood Bowl Theater in Lincoln on August the 21st. Full details, as always, on our website, 89.7theriver.com.
Hooray! We did it. Okay, what I'm gathering from everyone on the cam crew is that losing your diamond is substantially more common than one would think.
It absolutely is.
Insure it.
My dad lost his ring in the front yard.
Oh, really?
They had to come over with the metal detector to find out what was going on.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to finish this pop quiz.
You do it.
The phone is ringing. Would you grab it real quick? Hopefully it's not Marcus again.
89.7 The River, what's up?
It's not Marcus again.
We did. I'm so sorry. What we'll be to listen back next week.
We got more. Yeah.
Have a good one. I took a stab and wondered if we did. So
we got. I don't know what it is now. Phone's ringing again. Hi, The River. What's up? What up? Hey, buddy. What? How are you? Happy friggin' Friday. Let's do it. Well, that's. Nice of you to call. We appreciate that. Uh-oh. Do you want to talk to her? Okay, hang on. It's Rye Guy.
Who? Ryan?
Uh-huh.
What's shaking, bacon? All right. Have you lost a ring like everyone else has, apparently? Oh, it's the worst. What's up? No, don't apologize. Are you kidding me? Dude, I get it. Oh. Dude, that's awesome. I love when parents can't find babysitters. That's the best. So did you have a good time? Oh, did I lose you? Oh, go ahead. Sorry. Yes, now I can't. Okay, what'd you say? Oh my gosh, completely different band now. So sick. You know, never apologize, but also I was thinking about you and I was like, man, I hope Ryan got some tickets to that. Good. I'm so happy to hear. I'm so happy you had fun too. Thanks for updating us. You too. You have a good one. You too. Bye. I will be calling you, Tissy. Ooh, Ashley, did insurance ever buy you the new diamond? Like, they should buy you the new diamond. Or do you need to lose the whole thing? Because you could just lose the whole thing if you need to get it replaced. Broke the stone in my military ring. I need to get it fixed. Hey, if that's insured, boom, again. Otherwise, maybe someone will take pity on a military ring and help you. My dad's wedding ring, I've only seen it like once when I was a little younger, or a lot younger, I suppose. But he's a contractor, does construction. And so he was wearing his ring one time and I don't know what happened. Something happened where like he got hit in the hand or something, and they actually had to cut the ring off so he didn't lose his finger. So I've never seen my dad since I've been alive wear a wedding ring. And in fact, like, I didn't know that men wore wedding rings growing up. And I remember the first time I saw a guy wear a wedding ring, I was probably like sixth grade or something. And I thought it was so weird that a guy was wearing a ring, because I just didn't see that, because I grew up around farmers and mechanics and construction workers, and they never wore rings. And then I remember I asked my mom about it, and she goes, yeah, men wear wedding rings too. Oh, David and Phil have never been engaged. Okay, yeah. They sense since I didn't. Ugh. Ashley, that's annoying. This is why I want to punch insurance companies in the faces.
Wow.
Absolutely. Oh, hi, Chris. I'm sorry you couldn't sleep.
Okay, birthday's in 15 seconds.
Want it.
89.7 The River, brand new music from Glass Animals. It's called Creatures in Heaven off of their To Come album. It is brand new. That is a track that just got to us. So there you go. Brand new from Glass Animals. Creatures in Heaven, it's called, on a Finally Frickin' Friday. Always good for a new music Friday to have new music, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Oh, well, well, what's going on?
Fire. There we go.
You're fired.
Fired.
Producer's
producer,
out of here.
Producer, get out of here. We need a new one.
And they made it a week.
Oh, well, good job. Nice job.
All right, birthdays today. By the way, I missed one yesterday. My niece Sophie, her birthday was yesterday. So Sophie. Happy birthday, Sophie. Not Sophia. Don't make the mistake. Don't call our Sophia Sophie, and don't call that Sophia.
That Sophie Sophia. Sophia.
She goes by Sophie. She doesn't go by Sophia.
Oh,
if Sophie. She go, if you call her Sophia, she knows she's in trouble.
Oh.
Yeah, well, she's 20 years old. It's okay.
Oh, okay. That makes sense. That makes sense.
She's gotten used to it by now.
Yes,
all right, absolutely. Who's turning today?
Well, let's see here. Jake, I did send you some audio for this special case here. So
you want me to kill it a Fitty?
Yeah, kill Fitty.
Apparently, Fitty and Nelly have a real beef, by the way.
I feel like they all have beef. Dude, Ja Rule and 50 Cent, their beef is the best beef, because 50 Cent would buy all of the like front row by the stage seats at Ja Rule and leave them empty.
Yeah. All right, give us some birthdays today.
All right, well, we have to say happy birthday first and foremost to Saoirse Ronan, who is Hannah in Lovely Bones, and she's also in Little Women remake. She's an Irish actress. She's wonderful. Brendan Urie of Panic at the Disco is 37. Shannon Doherty is 53. Did you have a huge crush on her?
No, I thought she was kind of a B-I-T-C-H.
I know. Yeah. It always surprises me when people are like, I love Shannon Doherty. She's
got cancer pretty bad right now.
She did beat cancer.
Oh, she did? Okay.
But I mean, at her point...
I thought I had seen it was back.
I think you might be. I was going to say, at her point, because I know it was stage four a couple times, I think she's constantly on top
battling.
Of it.
Well, best of luck to her.
Best of luck.
I know she's not that way in real life, so...
Yeah.
Or maybe she is. I don't know.
I'm not sure.
I hope that she...
I've never met her.
...beats it. Anyway, who else?
Nick Hexum of 311, the lead singer.
Happy birthday, Nick.
Happy birthday. Amy Ray, one half of the Indigo Girls, is 60 today.
They will be in town next week on Tuesday night.
Heck yeah. We'll skate her a cake.
At the Astro. Okay. I will take her a cake.
Art Alexis of Everclear, singer, is 62 today.
I think that's pronounced Alexakis.
Alexakis.
Yeah, you know how Greek people are.
Sure. Andy Garcia is 68. David Letterman is 77. And the reason that I sent you that audio that you cut, I'm not sure why.
I didn't cut it because the song was over.
Oh, that was a short song. Tiny Tim. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Tiny Tim.
And if you know Tiny Tim, it's that. That's pretty good.
No. The song sucks. It doesn't matter who does it.
It's terrifying.
Or how well they sing it. It's
awful. Isn't it scary?
Yeah, it really is.
I thought you cut it because it was that scary.
No, I cut it because it was over.
Insidious used it.
We talked too much about Fitty.
I know we did. Sorry. Insidious used it, and I can never recover from it.
Yeah. Here's another voice that you won't forget. Here is Bad Omens along with Poppy. This one's called Van. It's 89.7 The River.
That was a good transition.
Yeah, who knew? We lucked out, didn't we?
Tiptoe to loops.
I can't wait to hear A Tale Untold do that one.
Ew. First of all, how dare you? Second of all, ew.
It would be great if the merch girl would sing it. Can you imagine?
Could be good.
I think it could be good.
Could be good.
Okay, I got to finish one. Oh, no, I'm done. Pop quiz is done.
Mm-hmm.
I hold you. I said two things to get Sophia in here, but she refused to bite.
Ah.
I went against nature. But we, our hearts crave violence.
I gotta say that off air. My bad.
Yeah, don't say it.
Anything I almost rude? Said, no, not rude.
I know.
It's a fact.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Turtles in a half shell.
Hero power. No, it's actually
turtle power.
Turtle power.
What did I say?
You said turtles in a half shell.
Heroes in a half shell. You idiot, Elise.
No. Oh, my God. They just threw away wind chimes.
Oh, this is making my skin crawl, dude. Oh, look at that. That's nice. I'd use that for something.
That is nice. Oh!
Dude, take that stuff to the freaking... There needs to be a separate pile to take things to the freaking restore.
Absolutely. Like, that should... Those windows... I understand
there's a lot of garbage there, but there should also be a restore pile like, hey, this is going to the restore.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's what... That's
wasteful.
Oh, there's a Black Widow.
Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness.
Violence against nature.
What concert is Monday? At CHI.
Let me look.
Oh, Journey.
Oh, yeah. Journey. Oh. I got you over here.
Okay. Crying now.
Oh no. Yeah, of course.
Why would I start now with you, she says. Oh, Rachel, daughter.
Oh, Rachel looks troubled. Rachel looks worried. You feel for these people. You really do. Oh, just a second. Makes my heart sad.
Gross. Brian would like you to call him.
Ooh, I don't know if I have time, my dude. We got like a minute.
No, not now.
Oh, okay.
After
the show. Brian, AAA. Yes. I thought you meant Brian Cans.
No.
Oh, I've just been so busy, Brian. I'm so sorry. I do need to call him, though.
Sophia sent us an email.
I saw it.
Okay.
Mute the mics real quick. So he was accused of, like, he's in the midst of being heavily accused of using other people's songs in other people's beds illegally.
Okay.
So.
Kanye's always going to be a douchebag, dude.
Kanye. So we haven't announced that we're not on that show yet.
Coming in hot, you know me.
Ah! And I'm gonna make it rain on the girl that serves me. And again, this vodka with Patron. Yeah, Aaliyah, we're off that show now. They decided that they didn't want locals, so.
Thirty seconds.
All right.
To the rest of your life.
30 seconds to life? Could you imagine?
We got 4 minutes to save the world.
Could you imagine, like, you get sentenced to 30 seconds to life?
No.
Like,
imagine if you got sentenced to 30 seconds to Mars.
I want to go. I'd rather stay here on Earth.
You're so stupid. I know. It's okay. I know I'm stupid. All right, here we go. .89.7 The River, 1,000-foot crutch. Exhale. Song's called Push off of that album at 8:54. Good morning. Finally, freaking Friday on the Morning Fiasco with Jake and Elise. Hello, how are you?
Hi.
I hope that you enjoy this beautiful weekend ahead of us. Highs in the mid-80s. Today, 68, sunny, and Monday would be a good day to take a extended weekend as well. That will be a great day as well. It's going to be a great day. 85, and then that night, a slight chance of thunderstorms. It will be a bit breezy as this weekend goes on. Not too shabby today. Monday, 36-mile-an-hour gusts. It will blow in a storm. Showers are likely on Tuesday. So that is what's happening. Hopefully, we are out of the cool weather, though. Knock on, knocking on heaven's door. There you go.
Wow, same page.
Time for the pop quiz, baby.
Pew, 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 pew.
Okay, if you missed the news yesterday, O.J. Simpson passing away the day before yesterday, due to a long battle with cancer. They announced it yesterday. The memes are all over the place, however you feel about the guy. He lasted 30 years longer than his ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and Ronald Goldman, who were stabbed by a still unknown assailant.
Yeah.
Here's what else happened in 1994. It is time for your pop quiz, Elise.
Okay.
March of 1994, the People's Republic of China got its first ever connection to this.
I don't.
It's in 1994. What was going on during then? How busy was Al Gore during that time?
With the internet? Yeah. Oh, the internet.
There you go. Boom. She got it. Oh, hold on. You know what? That gets...
I went too complicated because I was like, well, Hong Kong...
You were so Avril Lavigne on that one.
Well, Hong Kong was, you know, a British... Yeah, and then I just...
Okay. Yeah. Number two. The rock world lost this legend on April 5th, 1994.
No clue.
Yes, you do.
Kurt Cobain,
yes.
Wow.
Nirvana had played at Xarban just 4 months earlier with Shonen Knife and the Breeders opening that concert.
Wow.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hold on.
I got that one.
You did?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
How dare you?
I gave you the special right answer. Number three. This also occurred in 1994, May 10th to be exact, but it was only the partial annular variety.
The partial annular variety. Annular?
It just happened this week.
An eclipse?
An eclipse. Absolutely. There you go. Why do you say it with such a question mark on your face?
I just really wasn't.
Your nose is going to stick like that, you know?
I was not aware.
On May 26, 1994, this famous pop star married Lisa Marie Presley.
Michael Jackson.
Nice job. Good job.
Thank you.
All right. You're rocking and rolling on this one.
Here we go.
Things that happened in 1994. Number six, the number one song of the year was The Sign by this band.
I saw the sign.
Yep. Now what band?
Open up my eyes, I saw the sign. I feel like I know this.
You should know it. You just knew
all
the words to it.
Ace of Base.
Absolutely.
I saw the sign.
Okay. Number seven, as we are on our pop quiz of things that happened in 1994. This top scripted show on TV, not reality TV, the top scripted show on TV in 1994 was this Fixer Up sitcom starring Tim Allen.
Okay, with Tim the Tool Man Taylor, it was called Home Improvement.
It was. You are correct. Number eight, the internet got real in 1994 with the founding of both Yahoo and Amazon. An entrepreneur named Gary Crimmon, who founded Match.com, eventually first registered the domain blank.com, which isn't surprising since it was a man that did it.
I don't know.
Not even a stab?
Okay, so it's like the earlier form of Match.com?
I'm not sure if it was that was the intended purpose of this thing.
I don't know, hookups.com?
It was sex.com.
Oh, goodness.
Sex.com was what the, wow. was the internet handle that he founded.
Aggressive.
Number 9, you won't find a World Series champion from 1994 because the series was canceled because of this.
Was it a bombing of sorts?
No, it wasn't a bombing of sorts. It was a player strike.
Oh.
Half the players were on strike that year. No World Series in 1994.
Why were they on strike?
That's one of the cool things I have. I have a World Series baseball from 1994.
That's wild. But, yeah, never been used.
Never. Well, no, obviously not because it didn't happen. No, they were on strike because they were trying to get the collective bargaining agreement going. So.
Okay.
And finally, number 10, a huge sensation for kids. The season finale of season 1 and season 2 premiered of this superhero series.
Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
What? How did you know that?
That was my favorite show. Jason was my first crush.
Right. That's your pop quiz. That's your pop quiz. Have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you next week.
Bye.
Bye, guys.